One, and today we're going to be starting with Mega Man X. Now, what's interesting is that I've actually played three of the four games from the first four games. The only one I have not played is Mega Man X3, but I will get to that later. And with everything said and done here, we will begin. Just gotta do one more thing. There we go. Alright, what's new about this is that there's a little thing called Rookie Hunter. And that basically is just lowers the difficulty. But the first Mega Man X game isn't really that hard, so I'm not gonna bother looking at it. So I might as well just go ahead and get started. These are all based on... I know the first three are based on the SNES games. The fourth one is based, I believe, on the PlayStation. Mega Man X4 was also released on the Sega Saturn, if I remember correctly. Good. Alright, with that said, let's officially begin the game.
Let's go.
one of the new features I liked about Mega Man X is that you can actually wall kick your way back up. That coming. I've never died before in this stage, and now I gotta start all the way back from the beginning. Joy. I guess X isn't that impervious after all. What's unique about this fight is that even if you're down to your last unit of health, you don't die. So for the sake of time, we're just gonna let him capture me. course, there's everybody's a favorite.
Zero.
Kind of like that last part there, you should become stronger. Wow, where do you instill confidence in someone there, Zero? Not to boast or anything. It's always good to have friends like Zero. Not yet. And here are the 8 Mavericks. And I do know the order. First, Chill Penguin. First upgrade. Now there is a password you can put in to bypass the upgrade and have Chill Penguin beat at the same time. I do not remember what it is. Thank you. teaching them how to do Ordeal. Battle. Now there's two ways you could go about this here. One, you can go to Spark Bandrill stage, or the way I prefer to go is go to Storm Eagle stage next. We'll see you in just a minute. And plus he's not that hard to beat. You can easily beat him without the Sting Chameleon. Or in this case, Chameleon Sting. Get away. Even if you do get hit, it's good to know you don't get knocked back far. very first energy attack. There's an extra life down there. So we're getting. Probably that does a stage better on later. That's much better. If I remember correctly, I think the helmet also protects your head from falling objects. hard. If you defeat a specific boss, it will alter the level design on some of the other stages. For example, I defeated Joe Penguin, and now Flame Man stage is frozen. This is just one of three stage design alterations. Alright. Get it. I know, this one's not easy to get. Can't get it.
Thank you.
listen to it. That's one or two things done. Moving on. Gotta go back here. Because there was a power up I missed. There we go, that's what I wanted. Whew. Alright. I don't know what happened the first time, but I'm not gonna let that deter me. Of course, if you get to Sigma's Fortress without this upgrade, you'll be given it automatically. But I prefer to just get it now and just get it done and over with. And then let's move on. Ah yes, this is the stage that most people take second, but I took the stage fourth and you'll see why. See? Normally there'd be a live, Yeah, normally there'd be live electricity running through the floors here, but since I went to Storm Eagle Stage first, that took care of that problem. But I can't get it right now because I don't have the right item. Whoops. Another thing, forgot to mention, if you went to Storm Eagle Stages first and then this guy's stage, he can't fire his lightning. He's pretty much powerless. Yeah, that's not doing you any good, buddy. into it. This is the stage where you can actually fill up your energy tanks and get extra lives. Of course, I'm pretty sure most of you knew that already, that this is the stage you can use to fill up your energy tanks to get extra lives. Achievement there, aren't you, pal? Hit me with your saw blade. I'm real proud of ya. One gripe I have about this game is that to dash you have to hold. I still say dash should have been just a tap button, you need to just dash across the whole distance. Other than that, I really don't have anything else to say about this game that I can complain about. Just for the record, I've also played X5 and X6. X5 wasn't too bad, but it was a little too difficult for my taste, and X6 was just... Another joyride. Take us all the way to the end. Normally doesn't happen. That normally does not happen, I swear it. Spent too much time dilly-dallying. Then again, I haven't played this game in years, so... Can't exactly blame me. Oh yeah, there was another thing I had to gripe about. The rookie mode. I mean, really? Trying to make a game easier, in my humble and honest opinion, this isn't worth it. I mean, games like this should be played the way it was meant to be played. Challenging, but fun. If you implement it in easy mode, it's like, okay, we're gonna take a portion of the fun away. Thank you. Nothing to it. I like the rippling effect of the water. I think it's really nice. That's what I was afraid of. Okay, I got a couple extra lives to spare, big deal. I haven't paid the second sub fight. Alright, rather take the hit than take the loss of life. Ready yet, do that. Dude, knock it off! Man, that's frustrating for me. That's not much of a reward. Bar. We're better not to fight that stupid sub again. Yeah, surprise, surprise. Jesus. How not can the periscope bout does something that I don't know what? Oh. Don't wanna around. Don't land on the spikes, don't land on the spikes. Ooh.
Yeah, thanks for the
cheap prizes there, pal. Yeah, going back to what I said about having just to tap the forward direction twice or just hitting the dash button once, about having it being a hold instead of a toggle. It's kind of a double-edged sword. Some like it, some hate it. Torpedo? It's supposed to be homing torpedo. It's like warming torpedo. Probably mistranslation. Or an intentional misspelling. Either way, weird results. Probably the boss with the strangest name, Boomer Kuwanger. A lot of people, from what I understood, had trouble trying to figure out what a Kuwanger was. Well, after a little investigative research, it's a beetle. I believe it's a type of Japanese beetle, if I'm not mistaken. I think. I'm not sure. You missed. items. This on. I missed. So...
go. That can do it. Seven hearts. And that's the last guy before Sigma. Got flooded. As far as I know, I think this is the only game that has stage alteration. go. Your bosses. By no stretch of the imagination, difficult. Dude.
And in my humble and honest opinion, it's probably got to be the strangest naming weapon ever in the history of Mega Man. Switch the first two words around of Sting Chameleon to get Chameleon Sting. Strange. Again. That's not for size, smart guy. Oh, not so smart, are ya? Worked in Boomer Kawanger stage, and it'll work here. It's a dirty tactic, but hey. Hey, somebody's gotta do it, right? Solved. I'll take him on. Sacrifice. Of course, any Mega Man boss is easy once you know their weakness. It's funny that Zero is bleeding from the mouth, and yet he's a Maverick Hunter. Thank you.
time for the rematch. Onto this. Gotcha. Whew. Fortunately, the other Sigma stages aren't as hard as the first, so that's... Thank you. I was right. No, I'm correct. Yeah, this is the one I want.
I could use Chameleon Sting against this guy, but I gotta save it for the boss up ahead. Then again, of course, though the background is static, whereas before, the ship was either going up or going down, I forget. Thank you.
me alone. Okay, I'll take that. Was just the right weapons. I think it is possible that I might be able to beat this game in one sitting. I'll have to see.
Come on.
Jimmy. Not to sound boastful or anything, but, now. Now, unfortunately, I'm not gonna be able to say the same thing for the other three games. Now, I can maybe X2 to an extent. But, I'll cross that bridge when I get here. Get away from me! Reflectus his tentacles. What, you think the Mr. Octopus in the ocean or something? Does. Cool. What am I waiting for? That. Alright. So maybe I can cut the tongue off a steam chameleon, but I know you can cut the trunk off this guy. I heard it is possible, but it's not easy. There you go. It doesn't make him any less dangerous, sadly. Thank you. don't like doing here, but I don't have much of a choice. Either that or just die in some full energy. But reserve my energy tanks. I take back what I said about Steam Chameleon about being the hardest boss. This is the hardest boss in the game. You'll see why. I might be able to pull this off. Last stage. So I'm probably gonna go a little over, but whatever. Done it before, I can do it again. My stream, my rules. This works. That happens. But that's something that needs to be fixed. Or maybe because the game got so bored with our gameplay, it said, you know what, I think I'm gonna pause this guy's game just for the heck of it. Talk about self-awareness. Kick your way up. You know how to deal with betrayers. Boy, isn't that the pot calling the kettle black? Sigma calls X a traitor, and yet it was Sigma who betrays the Maverick Hunters. So yeah. Bad doggy. Get over here. I don't remember. I know one of them is weak to spark shot, but I forgot who. Comes down to that. Because I don't want to. I don't have a choice. But the good news is that at least you start from Sigma, not that dog. I'm just trying to remember, one of them had a weakness to electric spark, but I forgot who. Either the dog or Sigma. But I got plenty of lives here, so I'm not too worried. So I guess you do see. Huh. Like I said, I forget his weakness. I'll just use a regular X Buster. Man, doggy. What's nice about this battle is that even when the dog gets hit, he gets knocked back quite a bit. So, by some distance between you and him. Yeah. I'm just trying to drive. regret defying me, blah, blah, blah. Come on, dude. I do know that sword does a lot of damage. Getting a little too close there, buddy. Battle. Thank you.
That, ladies and gentlemen, is Mega Man X. Here's the real question, Sigma. Why did you trade them? That's the real question right there. Of course, this sets up for Mega Man X2, which we'll get to another time.
There we go. Even more setup for a Mega Man X2. Alright, I think with that said, I will see you guys next time.